some of those bigger prizes in more detail. First, the Italian commander-in-chief, who insisted on surrendering only to the 8th Army. He evidently knows a good thing when he sees it. Already a much-travelled man, Messe is now due for a long holiday in Britain. I don't know whether he carries his heart on his sleeve or not, but he certainly carries a lot of stuff there. Oddly enough, it was only after he made a general mess of it in Tunisia that he was made Marshal Messe. An even bigger prize has also reached Britain, coming by plane from Gibraltar. General von Arnim, Commander-in-Chief of the Axis armies in Tunisia. At least he used to be. And we're all delighted to see him in the bag. He was thoroughly out-generaled, and his forces, which were some of the best that Hitler can produce, were out-fought. In Tunisia, as in the desert, our men, given the tools to finish the job, finished it. Up to the time of distributing this newsreel, von Arnim had not been promoted to field marshal. Rather hard luck, in a way. A second plane brought in more of Hitler's supermen, another batch of generals. Conspicuous among them is General von Fest, commander of the 15th Panzer Division under Rommel, and recently of the 5th Panzer Army under Arnim. Off they go to a prisoner of war camp. Altogether, 26 Axis generals have been taken in Tunisia, and including admirals and Air Force generals, over 100 since the beginning of the war. Von Arnim reaches his destination according to plan. Before his surrender, he's reported to have instructed his men to the British. They are unfair. Well, now that he's inside, he'll have unlimited leisure to go on hating.